Hello everybody. Today I've signed up for the Zwift Epic Race from Petit Boucle. Small belt-ish something? I don't know. It's an epic race. 60k-ish. 11 A's here. Thought about doing the tiny races. Super fun, sprinty set of tiny races today, but the timing is always a little off, and I like the timing of this race. And yeah, we'll see how I do. We loop around like we're doing RGB, and then we go left instead of right to the sprint finish. We go left and up the backside of the Petit KOM, and then down and all the way back around, and then left through the intestine and up the Petit KOM and down to the finish. So either both directions over the aqueduct, lots of flat. All cats race. Kind of be the A's and B's pushing together. We'll see how many A's want to do attacky, spicy things. And we'll go from there. Should be fun. Should be epic. Good luck, everybody. Let's race. Bridging up from the back fence here. No big deal. I pay to let others do the work. For the most part. Here we are. Alright. Lucky Jordy Bell. I have to look on various other listings of who's in this race. We're getting a good little strung out push here. Not too bad. Usual power-up suspects. Got the Zwift Play controllers. Still not sure they quite behaving, but I'll do what we can do. Bit of action at the front. too bad. A touch of damage at the back. This is just normal. Joe Thomas is here. Riding the beast. As he is. Welcome to do. Working through my comfort level and different resistance trainer difficulty settings. I'm up over sort of 75% now for this one, which might feel a little high on the climby bits, but we'll see. Somewhere in the mix, I will decide if, how, when, in general, not this race in particular, but in general, I might want to inject some more attacking energy into my racing in A. Generally, I'm pretty timid still. Kind of just happy to be here. If circumstances work out and I'm around at the finish, for sure I will dump everything I have out there. But in terms of burning matches, as the saying goes, not really looking to do much of that. There really are two main selection points today. Plus the aqueduct in each direction will be aggressive, the intestines in each direction. But really it comes down to the first test of getting up a reverse KOM together, which is not actually a segment. But and then the last one, you know, pushing up and over the top, if you can be attached, and then the race downhill to the finish, where, you know, if you've got 9 or 10 seconds, you can stay away, be right on the front. Good luck for that. So I feel like in my spirit, I would be tempted to do more, to agitate, to try to cut slices through the field through effort. Hard to do that though, and the cost of being wrong is so high. Well, we'll see. Yeah, folks are talking through, letting this B rider go. Be the dream, right? Yeah, even on this 1%, I can feel the trainer difficulty, as I should. When it's easy, when the settings, on the easy set setting,
some of those just kind of blur. I don't really feel them, and that's a little bit off. That's fine though. I mean, the context here is that I have no front derailleur. I just have a big ring, 50 in the front, and 1128 in the back. But I can't really. It's, you know, it's designed for a front derailleur. I just don't have one, so I can't shift into the small ring. So that does mean that it's not designed to cross over. So I can't really use the 28 or, I don't know what the step is exactly, 26, 25. Basically, I get some pretty bad chain rub. So tuning the difficulty is a way to try to find the sweet spot where I get the range I need, but still have the power. And that's why I've been exploring it, about creeping it up. So that when I really need power on a flat sprint finish, I have it in that biggest gear. Or ideally, 1%, 2% false flat. Then I'm really working through the resistance. So yeah, 55K to go. Do not care about this solo beat rider at all. Others will. And we'll just kind of take it easy for a bit if we can. Strategy is a little interesting. So we get a couple more banners, three more banners before the start of the reverse Petit KOM. But I'm not sure I care. Maybe I'm foolish, but I might just keep the feather. And I can use it wherever I need it on that climb. Who is even out there? Eric Ding. Eric for the K. I do not know Eric Ding. He's not got enough time to be a factor at all. He is just floating, dangling. So, more power to him. So he wants to choose the first 10 minutes of this race. More power to him. Of course, if the aqueduct goes bonkers, I'll use the feather there and be quite happy with that. Absolutely no reason not to, honestly, so maybe I'll just do that no matter what. Got two two banners after that, the top, and then the balloon sprint. It feels like these days aqueduct is a hard one to make a break stick over, like a, make a split, I should say, not a small break, but yeah, you get across with, you know, half this group, and you see a good sized gap, and you think like, all right. The motivation is just hard for the front group to maintain the pace versus the chasing group, where it's do or die. So the idea that we want to really go deep on the aqueduct doesn't really add up. And there's our catch. Nice job, Eric. You were the story of this first part of this race. I look for counterattack, normally, but no. It wasn't really a meaningful catch. Seconds. The Alessandro, not sure what happened there, but they're off the pace. And then another 30 seconds or so to probably the proper chase through C's and so forth. So definitely have plenty of C's hit still here though, so I don't think I've seen any D's, but doesn't really matter. I mean, that's gonna be the story. Sort of obvious. It's you're in this group or you're not. And whatever happens down the road, this is kinda it. People getting dropped here, I should say getting dropped from this group at any point, have a great chance to get home before anyone catches. Because we just establish so much of this pace. But it's a long race. If people are truly at the limit holding this pace, they could blow up. And then maybe be a little bit sad later on. I certainly, you know, look at my graph as an A rider. Green, blue, gray. Green, blue, green, blue, gray, green, green. A little spike where I did something, I don't remember why. Just the, maybe that little 4%, 5%. Nothing. All good. Not gonna use the power up here, but gotta watch. And now there we go. People dropping power up, and pushing on the cobbles is definitely a thing. So you really wanna be near the front. Not too bad here. Maybe that one rider was hoping others would. Well, now we'll see. Mary A. Alright, this is legit. I'm into it. I'm on top of it. about that. Bit of bumpy sequence into the aqueduct. Not too worried. Thank you. fun, but and we did do some damage, but it's just hard. And the next group isn't even that far back. So, not a great effort, honestly. Not a great decision, but fun. Gotta try some things. There's this catch. The effort, like the idea, but I don't have the goods to maintain that, and even that effort was just me being a little restless and impatient. So do what we have to do. Recover here, focus on the climb. Seconds back. And one guy up the front. Good effort there. Good timing. It is what it is. They have 44K solo in them. They deserve it. Well, likely they will think better of it, and we'll see. All right, the draft is not a terrible power up for this climb. Would have saved those feathers. Well, what do I know? All right, 13 seconds. Still more than one C with us. Fremont, Anderson. Good job on their part. Reading the situation. Seconds. Oh yeah, he's putting down 5+. They are putting down 5+, so at some point you just have to let him go. At least I do. Like they're good for the effort. Maybe not holding 5, but 4.8 is their 20-minute number on good power. They're coming. Not, not that surprising. I think it's one. Okay, one is coming. Need to do anything fancy here. Stay test. So much steering here. It's great. Thank you.
All right, set this little rise, and down to the next bit.
Foxy gave it a good effort, but lost quite a bit of time there. So they are officially in no person's land. A good, from the looks of it, a good sized chase group coming 1 second, 1 minute off of our pace. A little bit of a drag and then a sharp spike, and it bends up to the right, and then it flattens out again, falls flat, and then some kind of painful steady grind. It is manageable, but not up to what other people want to do here. I have the draft, and my heart rate is great. Even though I definitely worked more than I should have up to this point. I wonder if the fall, the fake secret power up banner is still there. Right around there. Plus. That was pleasantly reasonable. Some damage though. Let's see. How's that coming back up? That's enough, bud. the last C dropping. Oh, they're still trying though. A little dig there. See if anyone was hooked at the back. They were not. Alright. Minute and a half. Cutting zero. They're not bringing it back. Well, you know, that was a good effort. That was not crazy. I pushed a little at the top. It was a little bit steeper, harder than I remembered at the top. Again, just pushed a little. Just slammed the door on the C's, whatever that's worth. And we have, what, 3 B's. So that's your B podium. And then 5 A's with second place on the line. And we got a lot of ground to cover here. We will come back to this, go back up that Petit KOM the proper direction, which is 5 minutes of hell. But yeah, we'll see. We'll see what we're going to do. I can do. There's really not a lot of aggressive action there. I was the aggressor. To my point earlier about wanting to find time, I guess today's the day to poke at the bear a little. I feel okay. 119. Heart rate is just cool down. So nothing to worry about here. No one's coming to get us. No scenario where we catch cutting zero. I don't even want to be second wheel here, honestly. All right, 30K to go. Far front. Huh. Okay. And then one of the B's. Oh, that's C. Is that one C or both of them? That's pretty unfortunate. Not they're strong enough to do that, but maybe we're just, I mean, like I said, recovery pace, cool down pace. Maybe that's just on us. 4 seconds back to Fremont. I mean, yeah, Pete and Fremont were chatting before. Oh yeah, they're on. That just kind of closes the door on their win. Put that one in the trophy case. You'd love to see it, honestly. I'm not gonna cast any shade. You know, I never really raced B. I never really raced C meaningfully. Maybe a couple in the early days. Quickly got bumped up to B. But there were plenty of these types of races where I was a B. Just thrilled with that sort of scenario where I catch a fast A group and, just ride the bus to victory or podium or whatever. So, you know, you can say what you want about their C, they should be B. That argument never ends. I'm just gonna look at the positive. Fun feeling to feel strong, to be able to bridge up like that, or catch on like that. But really, the big story is just that they were able to get over the climb, almost in contact, close enough that little move was even possible. And I could have sworn the other C, they were pretty close together, so if Fremont put in a big attack to make that move, all the better. Now this D Cornelov B rider. Don't care about. The two other Bs here probably should. Not quite dangerous enough, but let's see. I fell asleep a bit on that. Hey, counterattack by Legro. Very good. Very good move. But, just tough. Tough to get away. I like it though. That was a bit grippier than I wanted it to be. But totally appropriate for this race, at this point of the race. I put in the effort. Not too bad. It's just not long enough to really do that much damage. We already know that this group is strong, so this is kind of the story. And so not a lot to worry about. Even people maybe putting some attacks in. This Fremont dude is getting some time for the cameras. Why not? We all learn a lesson from this brave sea rider. Thank you. there might be a little bit of weakness there, but once again, no. So at least you go. Adjusted my table and my fan. I have much better airflow. Fremont again. Why not? 51 seconds. The other C is, I guess, just the two other B's. Two B's. Yeah. Doesn't matter. Not likely we'll see them again. I feel like the two yellow jerseys are pretty strong. Not sure I know who's who here. Yeah, Legros. And they're all pretty damn strong. Alright, well, come down to 5 minute power. Let's see what people can do. I'll hang on to this feather. Fuel. Well, no matter what, this is going to have to be a fun race. Glad I'm here. I feel like I have okay chances. Hat tip to Catanzaro. I never never really in the same race as them. What's happening here? Let grow. Why? 1.3, 0.1, 0.0. Well, they hit their hour. And they're out. Alright. Well, I'll improve my chances. It is a great workout. That's what your time budget is. Show up, get your workout, enjoy. They put some effort in. Here. Nothing too bad. You're in. So what does that tell us? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 A's with 2 remaining podium spots. Top 5 is in the bag. good effort on their part. I was watching the back there. Didn't quite hit the gap. He might have pulled through. Just didn't see it. Was much happier to let them do that effort. Enjoy that draft. A bit of wheel sucking there. No shame, no apology. That's just racing. Alright. This little inversion pace line go. 1C, 3Bs, and 4As. K to go. The last 3K or so are a ripping downhill. And the roughly 3K before that is the Petit KOM. Not even sure it's all the 3K, but do something, I don't know. And we'll rotate through here, through on the left, we can see what they say. Tail of the tape. I got the intestines and the rollies. You know, you start thinking about who wants to do what. Looks like the other sea rider might have dropped out. This is one of the issues of these epic races. But that's part of racing. If you've got the goods for the distance, and the time, the commitment. Alright, let's focus on Marina's sprint since we just went through it. Let's see if my rotation. I'm paying close enough attention. Not that it really matters. It is what it is. 5 minutes. Got the feather. Got the bike I want. Zero. 30 seconds through here. I'm not sure we're going to even put that number to the test. He's just locked in. Do our time trial. Yeah, I would have kept that. What do I know? All right.
Kowiecki.
At least it looked like we did. Maybe it was a glitch. There, I lost it. Someone else. Lost somebody. Got Mazzara rolling in 2.3. Maybe realizing nearly 3 minute gap is safe. I don't know, that's picking up a little. Trying to keep an eye on him. He's definitely the strongest one here. Or I should say has ridden like the strongest one here. But I'm in the conversation, so I'm sure they've figured that out about me. And then it's really just the Kobiecki. The other A, still standing here. So, this comes down to this climb. And we'll see. No real sense that anybody's particularly weak in terms of sprinting. Anyone burns a feather here, they're off the team. Arrow, truck, those are both reasonable power-ups to burn. Certainly the arrow and the truck is you just roll the dice. You get another truck. Great. You get the feather. Awesome. If you get the arrow. Well, you can't win if you don't play. Alright. Not really sure. What other folks have. Those two bees are. Yeah, that far back. If they just did the same banner. 30 seconds, yeah. Well, good for them. That'd be awesome if they could have more to say about the outcome of this race. Try and hang on for the bottom several switchbacks. Hopefully save my feather. And then if I have anything, go all in for the last three short switchbacks. That's the plan. See if I get punched in the face.
threw me away. Sixes. I give him credit. That's really impressive. I didn't want to use my arrow, but clearly that was my only real shot at it. Well, I have to be happy with third. I had a good race. Billings rode great. Spent a lot of time in the wind. Boucle, we actually did the right thing at the right time. Oops. Shoot. Nice job. That was fun. Very happy with my attack. Thought I had cut up the gap. Just didn't though. Used a super tuck and maybe needed to put more power down, but wanted that recovery. And then yeah, boy, that is one I need to dig a little bit deeper into to think about losing that wheel on that downhill. Maybe they're just heavy. We'll find out. That would explain a lot. Super big credit if so for their effort on the climb. But maybe they're just strong. I saw the numbers they were putting down, and that was a lot. So give them credit. They earned the silver. Rider in the front backed off a lot. They were still there on the climb. You can see them in the switchbacks. But there's never any doubt there. I have all that time in the bank. Alright. Well, that's a podium. And a tough race. And I felt really good. My continuing effort adjustments in terms of how hard I go, how many days in a row. It's starting to feel really good. Like today, my legs felt really good. And I was maybe a little too jumpy as a result. So that'll be another thing I can work on improving, is trying to stay cool
even when the legs wanna pounce. Yeah. Nothing record breaking, good solid effort. 85 experience until next level. Yeah. That'll come soon enough. Alright, that was another fun one in the books. Thank you all for watching. Until next time, ride on.